What's going on, everybody? Today is July 12th of 2021, and while historical decodes are nothing really new on this channel, this is the first part of a new series called Decoding the Past, where we look at events in history, as well as artists and their defining works of art. And in this version, or this episode today, we're going to look at Hunter S. Thompson, who, of course, is best known for the book and subsequent film, Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas. All right, so Hunter S. Thompson, as we see on the right here, a founder of gonzo journalism, truly one of the greatest contemporary authors of our time, I believe. And as his page states, Thompson remains best known for Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas. Now, Fear and Loathing was first published in Rolling Stone in 1971. However, it wound up being published as its own book in 1972 on the date July 7th. So in this video, we'll take a look at why this particular date is so significant. Although Hollywood wanted to turn that book into a film in the late 70s, it took over 20 years before the film was finally created and released in May of 1998, and we'll take a look at why that date is significant as well. And we'll also glance at the two lead actors in the film, Johnny Depp and Benicio del Toro, as well as the man who directed the movie, Terry Gilliam. Hunter S. Thompson was a big football fan, and prior to his death, he wrote a poem called Football Season is Over. So we'll actually end up looking at how Hunter S. Thompson's death may be numerically connected to the move of the Raiders to Las Vegas in 2020. We start with the gematria of the phrase fear and loathing, which in the standard reduction or Pythagorean method yields a value of 72, and 72 was the year in which Fear and Loathing was published. The author's name, Hunter S. Thompson, sums to 72 in both standard reduction methods. You'll also see 72 in the reverse Pythagorean method. Hunter S. Thompson even has alternate birth numerology of 72. Notice how Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas shares the same 109 gematria with Thompson's full name, Hunter Stockton Thompson. But consider how he was, or how the film was released in the year 1998. And Thompson's full name, summing to 109 and 98 in the standard reduction method. With capital letters, Fear and Loathing equals 187. The date that's written 18/7, July 18th, is Hunter S. Thompson's birthday. The 187 also stands out because Hunter S. Thompson, in the year 72, followed Richard Nixon through his campaign trail. And the name Richard Nixon, if I recall correctly, does equal 187 as well. Now, before looking at the release date of the book, I want to point out a really interesting gematria riddle with the title of the book. Fear and Loathing has a subtitle called A Savage Journey to the Heart of the American Dream. In the alphabetic order, this subtitle sums to 443. Adding the subtitle to the title of the book sums to 4,430 in Jewish gematria. You get a 443 there, and a 443 here as well. Now this is significant because the number 443 is a prime number divisible only by 1 and itself. And as we see, 443 is the 86th prime number. The number 86, pretty significant to Hunter, whose first name sums to 86 in the alphabetic order, so does the word loathing. But more importantly, the city of Las Vegas has gematria of 86 connecting to the title of the book. The book was released on July 7th, 1972, a date that had numerology of both 86 and 23, matching the ordinal and reduction value of Las Vegas. The date July 7th is a lot like the number 77, and notice how 77 has matching gematria with Las Vegas of 49, which is, of course, 7 times 7. In a cipher called Satanic Gematria, Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas sums to 1119. The book was published 11 months and 19 days after Hunter S. Thompson's birthday. So, after the 1972 publication of the book, about 26 years later, we had the release of the film, Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas. Notice how the name Hunter S. Thompson sums to 1350 in English Sumerian. This represents the number 135 in numerology since zeros are ignored. This matches the ordinal value of Fear and Loathing. This story takes place in the Nevada desert, which has Jewish gematria of 135. And in the film, Hunter S. Thompson's sidekick is Oscar Zeta Acosta Fierro, whose name in that same Jewish cipher sums to 135. Now, I don't often talk about the rule of Kollel on this channel, where you can subtract one from or add one to each or any gematria value, but I think the alignments are pretty significant here. Johnny Depp, who played Hunter S. Thompson in the film, was born exactly 1,351 weeks after Hunter S. Thompson. We know this is significant because his co-star, Benicio del Toro, was born exactly 1,351 days after Depp. The film's May 22, 1998 release date fell exactly 1,350 weeks after the publication of the book in the year 72. Again, Hunter S. Thompson summing to 1,350 in Sumerian gematria. On top of this, the 135th prime number is 761. This number connects us to the film's director, Terry Gilliam, whose name sums to 761 in Jewish gematria. The film's release in 1998 was 27 years after 1971 when it was first published in Rolling Stone magazine. Fear and Loathing sums to 270 in the reverse alphabetic order. Now, in ordinal, the city of Vegas sums to 54. The movie was released, again, May 22nd, 1998, which was a date with a life lesson number of 54. On top of this, May 22nd leaves 223 days in the Gregorian calendar. And in ancient Hebrew gematria, this is the value of Las Vegas, Nevada. In the year 2017, we had the second largest terror attack on American soil in history. And that was on October 1st in Las Vegas. Hunter S. Thompson's death on February 20th happened to fall 223 days before October 1st. And in that shooting, gunfire fell from a casino. And the word casino equals 223. The Mandalay Bay Casino turned exactly 223 months old on the same night of the shooting. Again, all tying to the Hebrew value of Las Vegas, Nevada, 223. In English extended gematria, fear and loathing sums to 522. 522 is a lot like the release date of Fear and Loathing, May 22nd, written 522. Now, May 22nd can also be written as the date 22/5. The number 225 is the ordinal value of the name Hunter S. Thompson. Notice how using prime numbers, the word drugs equals 225. But look at the date that Hunter S. Thompson died. On the date 220 in the year 05, like 225. In fact, Thompson also died 225 days before that year's annular eclipse. Despite the fact that he died on February 20th, there was some text in Thompson's typewriter that read February 22nd, 05, which would have been 2 days after his death. And the date February 22nd seems to be quite relevant to this as well. First of all, I want to point out how fear and loathing sums to 81 in the reverse reduction method. In Sumerian, fear and loathing sums to 810. 81 is the reverse value of vagus. And Hunter S. Thompson has primary birth numerology of 81. Well, the date February 22nd, which was written on Hunter S. Thompson's typewriter when he died, fell exactly 81 months after the release of Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas. The curious detail about Hunter S. Thompson's death is that he was clearly suffering from depression, but it was pretty unique. Prior to his death, he wrote a poem called Football Season is Over, in which he commiserated about how there were no more games to watch, and this time of year was routinely very difficult for Mr. Thompson. I found it curious that the name of this poem, Football Season is Over, has matching 244 gematria with Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas. And on this channel, I discuss how 244 is a significant number connected to the kill code, as in Hebrew gematria, the word for kill sums to 244. And to make this more interesting, the word football is a near supermatch in gematria with Las Vegas, Nevada. Now, whenever we're talking about football, it's important to understand how important the number 22 is to the game. In both European and American football, there are 22 players on the field at all times. Using the alphabetic order, National Football League equals 220, again reflecting the number 22. 22 in numerology known as the master builder number, which sums to 220. In the year 2020, the Las Vegas Raiders came into existence, moving from their previous home of Oakland. And not only was it in the year 2020, but it was on the 22nd day of 2020 in which they announced their move. Now, the year 2020 was 22 years after the release of Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas in theaters. Measuring from the Raiders' move to the 22nd anniversary of this film was 121 days, or a span of 122 days. When Hunter died, there was just one word found on his typewriter. And notice that word is listed here in quotes, the word counselor. And check out how the word counselor has gematria of both 121 and 122. On top of this, the Raiders' announcement fell 245 days after the anniversary of the film's release. Both Las Vegas Raiders and Las Vegas, Nevada sums to 245 in the reverse alphabetic order. So the film Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas has a very clear theme. And that theme is drugs, which equals 69 in the alphabetic order. Director Terry Gilliam was born on the 22nd of the month, just like how the film was released on the 22nd. This means he was exactly 690 months old for the film's release, connecting to the word drugs. In the film, Hunter S. Thompson was portrayed by Johnny Depp. And check out Johnny Depp's birthday of June 9th, written 6/9. On top of that, he was born in the year 63, which is the trigonal value of the word drugs, 630. Now, on top of this, the 69th prime number is 347. This movie was released 347 days after Johnny Depp's birthday. This means it was also 18 days before Depp's next birthday. 18, like the reverse value of Hunter S. Thompson. Johnny Depp was 34 years old for the film's release. That's how old Hunter S. Thompson was when Fear and Loathing was published in Rolling Stone and as its own book. Johnny Depp, also born in the state of Kentucky. Hunter S. Thompson, born in Kentucky. All right, everyone. Thanks for popping in and checking the video out. Please feel free to like, share, and subscribe, as YouTube algorithms no longer do this channel any favors. Peace, love, God bless, and we'll talk to you next time. See ya.